So parang pwede kang mag-lay na ng ground para i-target mo na in 2 years time, pwede ka na magtayo ng isang formal press council. So yun yung maganda siguro ng pag-aralan and then advice to other journalists in other areas if that is something that can work. In particular, we asked Jen Stan, Cagayan de Oro, tsaka San Juan.
The owners do not have to take part in council. As long as they give their editors full confidence and support. At saka, it's a misconception to think that the council is mainly for complaints. In the case of Cebu, we have had very few complaints. Not because the council is not widely known, but because it has also served another purpose, a forum for consultations. When problems arise, we hold consultations. For example, we consulted the priests on the coverage of the priests. We consulted the police on the rules affecting crisis situations, and so forth and so on. It is more known, better known, as a forum for consultations than a forum for complaints. But this serves a purpose. It tells the public that media is willing to listen to other sectors affected by media coverage.
Siguro, it can take many forms, eh? like in the experience of the Center for Community Journalism and Development, we've had partnerships with media groups in Iloilo, Palawan, for instance, and in Bicol, through media citizen engagement. These things became platforms for dialogue between citizens and journalists to address certain issues or issues that are affecting the community. So it doesn't have to be a formal council thing, you know, but it can take many forms, as I said. And then from there on, maybe we can move forward to having it become a council. So I think the more important thing is for people to have some sense of being owners, in a sense, of the media. And this is where accountability comes in, and this is where media literacy comes in, I think.
So the press council has served as a voice of the media community. And not only media community, but also the citizens, because a component, a vital component of the press council is the citizen. Cebu Citizens Press Council. And on many issues, the council has spoken out. For example, on bills pending in Congress, we have been speaking out for the past several years. And on pending legislation in the local legislature, the most recent was a ban on tabloids. Tabloids are acquainted with obscenity. So when the bill was approved, and sent to the legal committee, we were able to speak out, and they changed the bill. The proposed legislation was changed completely, except for one minor point, which we're still battling. Another issue which the council took up was the issue of reporters, columnists being summoned to the city council or the provincial board. The council spoke out, said, you cannot do that. So they dropped the idea of calling our reporters or columnists to explain what they wrote in the paper.
Do we still have time for 1.5 questions? The other half can come in later, the first one now. No more questions? You want to go shopping already? We'll wrap up the session and let's thank Attorney Siking Jack for joining us and of course for this wonderful session on safety. Thank you very much and good afternoon to all. Before I ask Romena to go down the stage, then we'll give you a multi-million peso worth of tokens.
Okay, that concludes the main forum of the 16th National Prayer Forum of the Philippine Prayer Institute. Maraming salamat po at mabuhay ang Pilipinong mamamayan. Pero we already complete some of it. So if anyone thinks of the last speaker on or the asthma or whatever, we use suitable then. Don't have to do it. Sige para. Para po tapos, muli po tayo, okay na po tayo lang. We'd like to invite all the members of the Philippine Press Institute, its partners, the moderators and speakers to be with us in the fellowship dinner at the third floor of the hotel, poolside at 6 o'clock. Okay, it's going to be fun, I hope. A little bit serious po isa, pero fun all throughout the day. Maraming salamat po at sa mga sadyante natin sa napakaraming universidad sa Luzon, Metro Manila at sa pang-dakang lugar. Maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat. And yung ibang hindi makakadalo bukas, you can get your certificate of attendance sa secretariat. Thank you very much. At yung mga iba pang babalik bukas, kasi optional naman yung bukas for the academic, you can do so tomorrow.